In May 1944, Sportsman's Park integrated its seating bowl. But it would be another decade before the roster followed suit. Fred Sy sold the team to Anheuser-Busch after the 52 season, and new team president Gussie Busch set out to make the team on the field resemble the fans in the stands.
He knew his audience, and he knew he sold a lot of beer to white people, and he sold a lot of beer to black people.
Gussie hired a scout named Quincy Troop to find him the right man to break the barrier in St. Louis. Eventually, that yielded Pacific Coast League star, tall Tom Alston. He made his debut on April 13, 1954, and he was followed on May 31st by pitcher Bill Greason, a successful Negro League hurler, but he only ever appeared in three Major League ball games.
There were three games that he'd probably like to forget. In fact, he made more money pitching in the minor leagues than he would make pitching in the major leagues, something that really frustrated him. He's getting the call up to the Cardinals, and his contract called for him to take a cut in salary than what he was making in the minor leagues.
On June 20th, he was optioned to the minors, spending the next five seasons mentoring up-and-coming Cardinals, including a young man from Omaha named Bob Gibson. Alston and Greason laid the groundwork for the Gibsons, Brocks, and Floods. But the two of them were the original barrier breakers. Their efforts are memorialized in this photo. 1954 was the first year the team photo was taken in color. Surely, a deliberate effort to memorialize the year that St. Louis baseball changed for the better. For Cardinals Insider, I'm Brett McMillan.